We'll say welcome to George Foreman's KO Boxing. I'll let the little screen play, because maybe we'll look out and actually make it through the first set of stuff and get a password. Manual up as if it matters. It doesn't actually tell me anything. There you go. There's our story. We're playing as George Foreman, he's our little Mac. And away we go. George Foreman against Lorenzo Bullet Luciano. Bullshit. Hey Netson, how you doing? Information Smoker Highway. Yeah, how was braving the outdoors? I think I saw they're planning to try to distribute masks to people. Hey BPN. How's it going? And Gerball, everybody's coming in all of a sudden. Not fun but manageable. I'm glad to hear that you're able to stay out of it mostly. I was lurking when you beat Rampart. This game is awful. Absolutely awful. Scooby-Doo. I think that's one of the games I want to try to play at some point as well. I've heard good things. I played a little bit on the GameCube. Got Legends of Zelda Tears of the Kingdom. Then you got your doctor's appointment done. I got my doctor's appointment coming up in a couple weeks. I need it. There's something going on with my head. Got your Kung Pao chicken bags. You got it all covered. You're good. Yeah, Rampart's one that I hear it's a difficult one. And I stole the manual from Gao, because I didn't have it before. Off of your Discord there. But I do not own the cartridge yet, so I can't beat it. I don't know if I'll ever get a chance to beat it anyway, because I got like 5 shit games in a row. Including this one, where I could not even beat the third guy and get the first pass. I don't even know if I get the first password from the third guy, but I couldn't even beat the first 3 guys in this game last night. So, yay. Alright, round 2, here we go. The strategy that I've developed is probably terrible, but it does something. It's supposed to be like a Mike Tyson's Punch-Out, but gone if I can figure out a good pattern or do decent damage to them ever. Super punches are virtually pointless. Here's my super punch. It basically did the same amount of damage as a single punch. Yeah, that's my fear, is that you just get lucky with some of those games. And I need to look it up, because you did it on a specific character, a specific difficulty. So I need to see, is there going to be a different ending for beating it on the hardest character? Because if so, that's my goal. Adds a fun little wrinkle to the mix. Yeah, I know they give you different like pieces and different amounts of time. I wonder if the text at the back is different. If it's not, then I'll just do normal. Yeah, it looked like the hit detection was kind of off on the enemies. You have to really lead your shots, but then they switch direction. Cool, you know. They always get up on the exact same count every single time, so it's not a surprise. This guy, I've never been able to do anything other than knock him down 4 times to get the full-on TKO. There you go. That's me, I'm George Foreman. Uncle Fester. Yeah, Glenn, to add fuel to the fire, Gerbal, I think Glenn is someone who came through one of the raids, and this is the only time I think that Glenn has voted, and he won his first poll. Meanwhile, you have not won a poll since, like, October of last year. So, yeah, he definitely picked a troll game here. I feel like I'm running out of troll games to be picked, at least in this, you know, in most of the categories, so I don't know. Yeah, I played Rampart on arcade. I played the actual arcade machines, but never otherwise. I understand this is quite a bit different, so I don't know. It'll be an experience. I probably should not have been watching you just to stay fully blind on the experience, but we'll get there. I'll probably forget it by the time I get to that game anyway. Alright, Tornado Collins. I've not TKO'd him. You win when you lose. Yeah, you get to watch me suffer through another Bible game pretty soon, because Chianeko won with Joshua. Battle of Jericho. That's coming up in a couple games from now. But first I have to get through Wheel of Fortune, and then I have to get through Bart versus the Juggernauts, which is another shitty game, semi-trolly, and then Joshua, which could be another like 50-hour game as well, unless it has... Maybe it has passwords where Exodus did not. But anyway, let's try to beat Tornado. Probably can't. The idea behind this is like you're supposed to like try to recognize patterns and do shit, but the only pattern I can recognize is when he's gonna do that. The rest of this is virtually impossible for me, and it's really hard to dodge too, because if you get like stuck in a punch and you're trying to dodge the left or right, you just don't get to. So yeah, he's gonna knock me down even though I've used two super punches on him. Yeah, of course he did. Because he pretty much only picks troll games too. He also just used channel points to do a bonus vote in the most recent poll. That's been pending for a long time because Pyramids of Ra took forever. I think virtually everybody in here has voted on that, but BPN, if you want to get in on that poll, I don't think you voted. So, feel free to visit the link. Hey Stevie, I hope I'm getting the fourth boxer tonight. I probably won't though, let's be honest. See, sometimes he delays it and then I get hammered. Saving your points. Yeah, I mean, save it for a good pull that you want to take advantage of, for sure. I forgot to use my super punch. I actually didn't realize I had one. I just hope there's a password after the third boxer. It might be four boxers to get a password, you know? The manual just says that there's a password after every single title fight. The manual also only shows nine boxers. What if it's 4-4 and then the title match against, like, you know what I mean? Like, maybe it's like Mike Tyson-wise, and the last password leads to the very last guy, and there's only, like, three passwords overall in the entire game, or two of them. I just have to not get knocked down a fourth time, and I think, you know, historically I've been. Fuck! Oh, I still have no life, okay. Huh. I'll never understand why the judge's decision goes in my favor. I knock him down once, he knocks me down three times. but yet I win the match as long as I survive almost every single time. It doesn't make sense. And I'm trying to think. I think I've knocked him down twice before, but never a third time. Yeah, it's like the one forgiving thing that this game has. Oh, rest in peace. Lance the Sheik. Pourquoi? I know that's not how you pronounce it. Alright, I have not beaten this guy. I don't think I've even knocked him down once. Even looks like Iron Sheik. But I have been... Yeah, see, blocking is nothing. It doesn't make a difference. Still takes off like just as much damage. And his hooks just do an amazing amount. I can't really dodge them very easily. And blocking is pointless. Weird question? Hit me. Everyone else is. See, like, because of, like, the round resets and everything, too, like, I can't... I did. Oh, weird cue. I thought you were saying weird question for me. Okay, so in this case, when he does his little charge, I at least have... No, he still comes through and... slugs me right after. I mean, look, he's like half health after all the fighting I've been trying to do. Knocked me down three times. I've hit him with two super punches. And now because of the round reset, he's gonna gain some energy back again. I don't know how to do anything on him. He's like his hits are just so powerful. Yeah, I see what you mean about the Q. The B is a little awkward as well. There, it's fine. Okay, so that is the title fight, though. It did say at the top of the card that it is the title fight, so... If I just throw a bunch of punches, like, will that, like, prevent him from hitting me too much? Probably not. Doesn't look like... That was kind of working for a little bit, in a way. Like, I obviously took a little bit of damage there. But I might be able to knock him down once. Maybe I have knocked him down one time. I think he was, like, huffing and panting, and, like, on his hands and knees. Oh, that's still not enough. There's a trick there where I can get, like, multiple headshots off of him. That's what I remember. Yeah, he's, like, convulsing. But now he's back. Like, I know his pattern, I just don't know what to do about it. He dodges when I try to counter in between his pattern. There's something about his charge, though. I think if... Alright, I have to go through Tornado again anyway. That up. Not easy. I'm not good at the pattern recognition stuff. Those are really hard. No, who's getting hit by the sound effects? Yes. I might knock him down twice. Overall. That was like the most balanced fight I've had against him. And he wins. That's really weird. He knocked me down less. What is their scoring system? Like, I had a higher percentage of punches landed on him. He knocked me down fewer times than before. I got more damage overall on him than I did before. But yet, for some reason, that time it was a loss. The judge is flipping a coin? Teach these young pups the ABCs of boxing. This is trash. Scooby-Doo game is really good. How far along are you, do you think? I think I own it on GameCube. Let me see if I can find out for sure. I do have it on GameCube. So if anybody wants to use their channel points to pick that, is an option once you get to that stage. This game is not good. It says you're about 40%. Yeah, if that includes collectibles, then you're probably quite a ways into the story already. Made a bet. Button mashing. I missed it. Shit. Wrong button. Wasted it. This is a bad start. I remember it took me like, I don't know, what was it, like 30 or 40 minutes just to beat this very first guy. And I'm sure I could improve my strategy even more. But it works. Down again here. Bullshit. Didn't register my super punch properly. And then I got hit by his more powerful garbage. Again, I dodged it. You saw I was off to the right, and I still took all the goddamn damage for it. Just forget it. I'm just gonna stay down. There's no way. Dumpster fire. Just stupid. Why call them super punches when they don't really actually do anything super? And maybe take twice as much damage as a normal punch, but that's probably generous. I know it's the same game name. If I had to guess, they probably cut a little bit of corners on the GameCube version. But yeah, it's basically the same thing. The other benefit to this game is that they do not remove your super punches if you get knocked down. I think Tyson Punch-Out does. You know how sad the ref is to be there. Down. I'm trying to get over. Oh, it'd be great if the game would let me get over. But like, if you're getting punched, then it eats your inputs. Wonder if I have to knock him down in round three, and that's what they look at more than anything. I tried. Didn't do back to backs, okay. Lose it for me. I don't know. It's fun beating my head against the wall. Ah, come on. There is a part of me that just kind of wants to run the poll now to see what games are coming up, just to see if I am actually going to get some good games. I mean, I don't think Little Mermaid will be a good game, but at least it'll be, like, short. Wheel of Fortune will be fun, I hope. I'm gonna draw that one out. And win all five prizes. That's all the positives. Wrong button again, fuck. Select to throw your super, so I'm hitting start on accident. Why did I miss that? Go. It definitely feels like it's that time of the challenge. We're getting close to half year. I gotta step it up. I'm gonna beat 50 games in a calendar year. Which would be the first time I've ever done that, by the way. I have not actually beaten 50 games in a year. Game Boy games, that is. I'm actually kind of close to 50 games in the year, like across all platforms. Already. I think, Pyramids of Ra might have been game number 44 for me. But only like 20-something Game Boy. 42. That was number 42. Still got me with it. I was in the process of dodging. Versus 61, I landed more pick punches overall. Surprised I didn't get knocked down there. Same percentage this time, and I got more punches landed. Oh, I might get him knocked down though. Probably won't, but you never know. Oh, so close. Yeah, he fucking bullshit. So, I mean, it worked like 5 times in a row yesterday, and now it's losing 5 times in a row, and I don't know. I don't feel like I'm doing anything different. In fact, I feel like I'm doing better. God damn it. Maybe I really do just have to knock him down in the third round, and that's all that matters. Maybe knocking him down in the second round is not good enough in the judge's eyes. Do you think a super punch to knock him down would make a difference? No, he's gonna get up on 8. Great. So I landed 10% more punches. I also landed almost double the amount of punches he did. Alright? He only landed 19 punches on me, yet I was almost dead. Almost wasn't allowed to punch him there. So there I landed 5 fewer. So, like, that was much worse for me overall. Probably because I went in for the kill at the end there. He's only knocked me down one time. He's about to knock me down again. Hey, Lord Irons, not really. No, in fact, I'm having a tougher time getting past the second guy than I was at the tail end of last night. I've only been able to fight the third guy once today. The rest of the time I keep losing to the tornado on the decision, and I don't know what makes the difference there. Like, the times where I'm basically... Basically, when I'm doing terrible against Tornado, I get the decision, but when I do well against him, it goes to him. I don't know why. But yeah, in the hour that I've played, I guess they're glove slaps. You can't actually tell what happens with the stupid graphics that they have in this game. The hour I've been playing tonight, I've only been able to fight the third guy once. I can't get back to him. Do any sort of strategy. Bullshit. I missed with the super punch, then he locks me into a goddamn other thing, so I couldn't even dodge. I'm ready to play Rise of the Dragon again. So I need to backtrack on that game. Got a game over. Or everyone, I don't know if you remember, at one point I got arrested because I was at the crime scene. But I'm gonna go back and try to not get arrested. I do have a save before I went into that place. I think that just caused me to run out of time, because I ran into like 4 cutscenes in a row that said, "Meet my demands, or I'll do this." And then just it was cutscene after cutscene, so there's like no chance to actually do anything. It's like, well, nobody met my demands, so I'm gonna do this now. I didn't have a chance, so. I think it's because I just ran out of in-game time. It seems like it's like a 3 or 4 day event in Rise of the Dragon. So maybe it's just like you keep trying new things and failing, and then eventually you learn what to do safely and just, you know, go through it real quick. Alright, so maybe if I knock him down on round 3, that'll make a difference. Well, he got me first. I've been knocked down twice. He's knocked me down. I've knocked him down once. Nope, I don't get it. I'm really sick of this game. I'm glad this is my last night of streaming for the week. I need a few days off of this garbage. Who knows, maybe the last six fighters will be a breeze. Great if I could actually tell what the hell's going on and like when I was successful. Or if the buttons were like responsive, that'd be cool too. Cool. I mean, I'm happy, but like, why? Wish I knew. Like, you don't get to see the stats for that third round, so like, I don't know if I can like, I can't gather any information. All right, second try against the Sheik. But. I landed 18 punches and took like a health bar and a half from me. I got 24 punches and he's at full. How the fuck did that first one hit me? Bullshit. I don't know, and I hate it, and I don't want to play it anymore. God damn it, why are sports games some of the worst ever? I hate the fucking dodge that never fucking works! So I got him to half health. Now he just dodges everything. How was I able to like stun him, stunlock him, so he didn't actually do that last time? And like now I just fucking can't. So fuck me. And as soon as I come out of everything, he does that. Okay. I'm hitting over to dodge and it just doesn't do it. It's like half the time, it just doesn't fucking do it. It's impossible to get a fucking hit off of him. Just miss with both my supers because he can dodge everything. I'm done. I'm done. I'm fucking done. What am I supposed to do when dodging doesn't work? I'm not hitting anything else except for left or right, and it just doesn't function. Thank you. I dodged as soon as he got up, and he still fucking hit me. God, fucking shit. Oh, God damn it. He hits too hard. It's not really telegraphed. I can't dodge. The button doesn't fucking work to dodge. This game is so unresponsive with its controls. You know how Mike Tyson, you can like do a quick jab and then like it's super quick and you can, you know, hit A, B and then over in quick rapid fire, and it works, and all three of those things register. Here, push the punch button. Now do the dodge button. And hope it works. But in the meantime, they can just do whatever the fuck they want. And that time I dodged, I was on my way to dodging, and he still hits me. I don't know what to do. I'm at a complete loss right now, because I can't just like sit and like do little piddly fucking jabs, because my punches do nothing to him, and his take off like a quarter of my health with each punch that he gives to me. So if I have to knock him down in order to win, if I have to knock him down once and then just make it to judge's decision, I have to be aggressive. I don't know where I can be aggressive. Because sometimes if I punch, then he just does a counter punch. So what am I supposed to do then? It's not like it's a pattern I can exploit and be like, okay, well, he just threw his punch. Now I can do 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Because no, as soon as I do something, he counters it with a different moveset. Punches knocked me out once and almost got me down again. That's what I'm dealing with. Motherfucker! Then he just dodges everything else. That's my best opportunity right there. Dodging, still got hit to the ground. What the fuck? What the fuck? What am I actually supposed to do there? You're just gonna swing away and fucking hit me no matter what I do. I can't dodge it. It's literally too fast to dodge. And once I'm hit, I'm like in a position where the button won't register because I'm in the middle of being hit. So he hits me a fucking again. I am out. I'm done with this. Spam attacks, just go full on fucking aggro on him, just like, just one button. Oh shit. Holy shit, that worked. Try me, pissant. Fuck! I missed it! Aggro is the way. I also being able to do like two super punches when he does his charge thing. Well. Wail on him after that. He gets stunned and then I can just like destroy him. Damn, he got me. Okay, I have a strategy now. Fuck, finally. God damn this fucking... I was honestly ready to just like give up and play fucking Sega CD the rest of the night. Me, you coward. If I wouldn't have messed up on that first charge, I might have had him. Alright, I have a strategy at least. Give me a second, I'm gonna take a quick little break here. Relax. Be right back. All right. Yeah, it's less about resting my thumbs than it is resting my mind and my heart. Okay, let's start from scratch. I never have to fight the Sheik again. Thank you. I do legitimately think that if I wouldn't have messed up that first super punch sequence, that I probably would have been okay, and I might have been able to knock him down. Oh, I miss with my super punch. This is making me want to do Colosseum fights in Yakuza. I haven't played that game in a long time because I was been going for Tears of the Kingdom. Still doing that, of course, but progress is slow. Whoops. That one I just mistimed, but we're gonna beat this guy, so. Boy, I feel like I just don't have the timing on that one for some reason. Well, he got me down twice, I got him down once. I don't know. I mean, I waited until the third round to knock him down, which I thought mattered, but tough. I don't know what to do about that. He can't consistently win. I know I don't know how to get him down like four times. Hopefully it won't matter if I can beat Cheek. Second time I wasn't able to dodge that for some fucking reason. Really poorly. Oh, I forgot to use the thing at the last second there. Whew. Wimburn, how are you doing? Welcome on in. Hercules was a long time ago. Simpler days. Glad to have you here. I'm on Twitch. Not enough. But I'm on like 3 days a week. So welcome. Appreciate you coming in and following. George Foreman actually had two boxing games on Game Boy, oddly enough. You got this one, which is like a Mike Tyson's ripoff that's terrible. It's making me really mad. And then there's a game called Foreman for Real. And I don't know... That's probably just a reskin of some other game, too. I'm still, like, this is like the first three fights. I've been trying for 4.5 hours. I have not gotten a single password. I can't beat the first three people in this. It's really hard. It's annoying. But glad to have you here. Was it good? Was Foreman for Real good? From what I saw on this game, it seems like the Master System version is a completely different setup than what we got on the Game Boy. No, but it looked good. Okay. If the controls work in Foreman for Real, then it's already miles ahead of this. Because this is, dog poo. Unresponsive. But yeah, as you probably saw on the YouTube channel, I'm trying to beat every single Game Boy game that was released in the US using original cartridges only. And so I can only play the game if I own the game. I might knock this guy down. We have a voting system here as well. Stevie, if you don't mind putting a vote form command in the chat there. Viewers can vote and get a pick of future games. We'll run the poll after this game. Or actually, I can do it now that I'm in between rounds. There we go. If you want to follow that link, you can vote on a future game. Right now we have two games active, which is a platforming and action game, then a fighting game that are available to be picked. You're basically put into a raffle. Subs get 3 votes, viewers get 1, and then you can use channel points to earn additional votes if you want to do that as well over time. And then after I beat George Foreman, we'll run that poll, and that will allow us to... get much closer to the first third of the Game Boy library. Once I beat game 167, we'll be 1/3 done. So we're only 10 away. But I gotta get through this mess first. I'm a little behind on my YouTube videos. Last one I posted was Terminator 2. Judgment Day. I think was one of Stevie's picks. One of your favorite games. How did I miss the select button? Mm-hmm. Probably lost. Oh, good, I won. I don't know why. Alright, come on, let's beat this guy. EBO title fight. It's pure aggro. Go full on. Yes. Okay. Shit. I'm trying to just dodge the punches. Okay. So, let's dodge right away to avoid that first punch, if nothing else. And then just start spamming up an A. Charges, I should be able to get his health down to nothing. Now, if he charges me again, then I'll be in really good shape too. Shouldn't have used the super punch there. Okay, it worked out okay. I got one back. Hopefully, he'll charge again in the next 30 seconds. That's three times down. I've been down, what, twice? Shit. Guess they gave him a freebie there. He still might beat me. Charge me one more time, bud. Charge me one more time. Please give me a password. GBO. Ah, damn. Okay. 4 hours, 45 minutes in. My favorite is a double pounder. I pound them with the left, and then I pound them with the right. Am I hungry? You bet. Hungry for the championship. I'm hungry for a password. Thank you. Okay. 4-3-2-3. The longest side is 4-1-1. 4-4-3, and then all threes all the time, and then the middle is a 1. Good thing I have a pad and paper ready. There's no way I'm putting that in my phone properly. I really hope that I don't have to go back and fight him again. Like, ever. Maybe he'll come back in a second thing. Alright. Okay, so now we're back to this. We're on to fresh hell. I mean, because it could be like Mike Tyson and some of these guys come back for like a harder second round. Alright, so Sonny Joe Dukes, according to the manual, not considered to be one of the greats in the heavyweight division, but like anyone his size, he can put you down with one lucky punch. So I probably just have to avoid the one lucky punch. Yeah, it's a very strange... I don't know how I'm going to enter that password. That'll be interesting to figure out how that password entry works. Can I just be completely aggressive on this guy too? Body blows. Body blows the way to go. Ooh, okay. That's the one lucky punch. I dodged that. Bullshit. I was off to the side. Didn't you see that I was off to the side? Oh, he does the undulating too, just like Luciano did. Okay, so at least it keeps my password. That's handy. As long as I keep the system on, which, you know, only tonight. Thank you. Look like I was able to cancel his super punch by doing a body blow. That time I couldn't get over. I hit the button to get over. Oh shit. I got him, but it didn't cancel his punch out. I don't have the timing on that. I know I can get a super in before he throws his super on me. Looks like honestly the up and A strategy is also working pretty well for him. So I might just try that. Oh, he didn't throw it that time. Okay. Still has me on the ropes. Okay, so yeah, if I time it right, then the super punch is really good against him. Yeah. For some reason I didn't think that was like an actual whatever. It didn't register in my brain as an actual charge attack. Right? Oh, so he waits till 9. Give me false hope. I have one sliver of health. Ugh. He's manageable. I just have to be diligent about not getting hit by a super punch. Earthquake Harley. What does Earthquake Harley say? No one knows whether he got the name Earthquake because of the power he possesses or because he's simply cracked. Watch out. Can I just do the same thing? Can I just do like up an A on him? He's definitely doing more damage to me than I am to him. Oh. Well, I tried to get my punch off at the same time and it didn't work, so... If I do body blows instead, is that worse? I'll try that next round. Yeah. Okay, so I'm not beating Earthquake my first try, that's for damn sure. We're really even right now. Well, I still don't really know what's going on with this charge move. Probably won't get a chance to find out this time either. Guess I just need to dodge it. I can't dodge two in a row like that. That's impossible. So I have to be able to counteract it somehow. Happy to have a relatively easy first guy again, though. Hurricane seems a lot more manageable than, Cheek. Honestly, even more than the Tornado. If I say Hurricane, I think I meant Earthquake. Whatever. Whatever his name is, the next guy after this. That didn't kill him? What? That didn't kill him? Oh man, he was a sliver away. I think I might have gotten a TKO. I would have gotten that one. Hmm. That's it, yeah. God damn it. Okay, so I hit him with the fucking special. Right? Oh, pause. I hit him with the special, and then he immediately does like two massively powerful hits. So clearly that's not the way to go. I can't, like, I'm not preventing the onslaught. But those are such rapid fire things that I can't dodge them. I don't think. Maybe one dodge will actually avoid them both? One dodge will avoid them both. I just don't know how to actually, like, do anything good against him. Otherwise. Can't dodge over there very easily. There has to be a good way to, like, get a power shot on him. Trying to avoid those secondary shots afterwards, because those are also pretty dangerous. A noisy night behind me. I feel good. Second round victory on this guy. Yes. Earthquake. Shake out the hands a little bit here. Just don't know what openings I have on them, you know? Things, you know, those two things in a row, or really, I think it's like three punches in a row. I just have to dodge at the right time. But I can't, that means I can't get the super punch off first, because then I do not have time to dodge. Yes. All right, it's fine. One for one. Oh, I should have. Okay. If I can survive through round three, I might get the decision, right? I'm landing a greater percentage of punches by quite a large margin on each. We'll each have three knockouts, unless I really mess something up here. I just have to stay alive, and I might have a decision. Damn it. Nope. I think I'm getting better at his actual pattern, though. I just don't know how to, like, really take it to him and give him, like, a good... powerful, thing. Yeah, that was better, because if I just, like, dodge a little bit after he does that super punch, then, like, I don't take a whole lot of damage from this guy otherwise either, so. So far, like, the second round of fighters is a lot easier to get a handle on. See, I missed the dodge on those two. I do two quick dodges and then the super punch. I usually it's the perfect timing to shout in. Okay, for some reason, again, that didn't work. Like, I got the timing, and I think I hit him, but it wasn't enough to, And again, one sliver away. Right, well... that's obnoxious. And state it. Alright, messing up the timing a little bit, but get down. One for one, but I have to like come from behind here and like at least I didn't get knocked down a second time there. I was so close. I don't know if I'm gonna win this one, but close. Like, I have the pattern down. Like, I know what the pattern is a little bit better now this time. Like, I learned it about halfway through that match to a greater degree. So, basically what's happening is if I sidestep him in the opening part, I can get like two or three jabs in, And then there's a couple sections of body blow where I just dodge to the side, dodge to the side. And then on the fourth one, I have to do like two quick dodges. And then after I do the two quick dodges, I can punch him in the face four times to get the super punch. So it's just a matter of like timing and trying to limit my damage. Shit. I had the timing wrong. If I would have had it right, I would have been okay. At least I got the knockdown before the first round was done. Much better health-wise. Nice. This should definitely get him down. There it goes. See, it's just the pattern. Like, that was the easiest pattern to, like, figure out, and he didn't, like, retaliate when I figured out this pattern, unlike some of the other earlier guys. Okay. Irish Tommy Morton. Annual set. Okay, so I've fought everybody from the first page now. I fought two of the three from the second page. Irish Tommy Morton, a seasoned boxer who fought his way out of the pubs in Ireland, Tommy has learned not to give in to anyone. It's usually his opponents who end up face down. That doesn't tell me anything about his strategy. I also have not fought Eddie the Pirate Preston, Tyrone Madman Mosley, or Larry the Surgeon Scott. Those are the three remaining boxers after this. If I can get through this guy. His strategy is to get me face down. That is very true. I'm gonna go full aggressive. Let's see what happens if I just do like the up and A thing. Maybe he'll be like the other guy. He's really knocking me really hard. That is a very big boy. He punches very hard. So, full aggressive is probably not the way to go with him. Where's my opening? Welcome on back. I am on the sixth fight. And I think I've hit another big wall in this game. I have absolutely no idea what the hell to do. Oh, I've been craving some terrible pizza. I've been like, purposely like the shitty fast food Little Caesars, Papa John's, Pizza Hut style, not legitimate restaurant things, just, I might only be able to give it one more shot tonight. At least we got a password, though, right? This round of three could be worse, though. I mean, the second guy I was able to figure out, thankfully. Maybe. I actually didn't look at the title card to see if it was a title match, if I was going to get a password after beating. Maybe I can like figure out his pattern too. Like, it's like waste a life learning his movements and figuring out where I might have a chance to punch. Maybe it will. Like, honestly, I don't think that some of the other guys have allowed me to do that. Maybe I'm just really not recognizing my openings. I hope I remember the pattern when I come back to this next week. You can see, like, I'm landing most of my punches, that's 94%, so I'm, like, doing really well on these. Oops. Just updated your Switch games. I have not done that in a while. Uh-oh. It may have triggered the endgame in Tears of the Kingdom. I am not anywhere close. I've not played in a while, though. It's been a few days. So I'm still trying to do general backlog stuff on top of everything else. So Tears of the Kingdom is basically like a weekend-only thing for me now. So after I'm gonna play this until I game over, then I'll stop, and then I'm gonna go back to Rise of the Dragon. That's gonna take up some of my Tears of the Kingdom time. I think I'm doing... doing okay in Rise of the Dragon, I think. I might be able to beat that tonight. There we go, just barely made it. Oh. Bandai and Namco went through the effort to translate Mysterious Tower from Japanese to English and even updated the title screen. I hope they release more Japanese. Yeah, I'm curious about Mysterious Tower, but if it's a puzzle game like people were saying, then I'm gonna hold off. I actually never watched the trailer of the announcement of the most recent four NSO's inclusions, so. I'm kind of puzzled out after Pyramids of Ra. Never played Tears of the Kingdom or any Zelda game before. Huh. The only Zelda game you own is the Game & Watch one. I mean, I enjoy Zelda. A lot of them are quite different in style. Like Zelda 1 and Zelda 2 on Nintendo. Completely different, obviously, but both very, very good in their own right. I love the 3D ones, although I never really finished any of the 3D ones. I finished most of the handheld ones at this point, if not all of them. And at some point I'll play the Zelda CDI games on this channel. Okay, let's see what happens with Irish Tommy Morton. Let's see if I can figure out what the hell he does. I'm just gonna, like, do defense. Wow, that does a lot. Okay. Alright, so his general pattern is like almost army like. It's like dun 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 dun. I don't know where my openings are to hit him. Alright, Nansen, yeah, have a good night. Yeah, I never really finished 3D once, even Ocarina of Time. That's one I probably should try to get to this year as well, if I have the time. Well, the only 3D one I've actually beaten is Breath of the Wild. Probably. If that counts. Yeah, have a good night. I'll be back on Monday with more George Foreman if you're around. The smoke doesn't get to you by then. Just stay safe out there. I'll say it right one of these days. Get me 20 times, less than 20 times, and knock me out twice. Sometimes when I punch, he counters with a different pattern, so I don't know what to do. Yeah, it seems very dangerous out there. I mistimed that. I lasted till round two for the first time, just by dodging a whole bunch. I'm trying to get the timing. Put the super punch down. I thought maybe after the first punch when he comes down, I would have time. It did not. I used it. I don't think I hit him with it, though. Yeah, all the Canadian wildfires. It's scary. It's been a very dry season over here as well. But thankfully we don't have the fires to worry about. I'm not sure where the opening is to use the super. comes down and he punches twice, then I can use it. That's the fourth knockout, right? Yeah. Okay, so that's a possibility for me. I think that's game over, though. No, it's not. Oh, I can go back to Hearthquake again. Hey, Chinooka, how you doing? I'm on the second round of people! So that might be a strategy for me. Just, like, pummel him in the face until I get the star power. Right? And then I dodge until he does his thing. Hit him with the super punch. Rinse and repeat. And hopefully knock him down, like, once and get the decision in my favor. I don't think that's a viable strategy, but that's what I have in mind because he punches so hard. I beat the first title belt guy by just going like full aggro. And then I learned that if I did two super punches on him when he was charging, that I was able to like stun him and really get like a bunch of damage off. This guy, I don't know. I could probably do the same thing somehow, but I just don't know. I haven't tried him enough to learn. Yeah, most of the time the Canadian wildfires or even California wildfires are affecting the west coast of the US, but this time it's the east that's getting the brunt of it. But this guy has a very easy pattern, thankfully. Nah, I don't think that's it. I'm not gonna make fun of the situation. Dodging isn't working the way it should. There'll come a time when Chicago faces the same thing, I bet. As far as I know, we're not getting any major smoke over here. I don't know why I'm hitting A and B rapidly as if I'm the one that's down. Granted, I didn't really, I mean, air quality is bad, generally speaking, but I don't think it's from the wildfires. I think that's mostly east. I don't know, I wasn't paying enough attention to the weather today, so.
Thank you.
Well, if the Windows taskbar says it, it must be true. And getting all the way knocked out. Okay, yeah, this is the title fight, okay. That's encouraging. He was an 8 count on his first knockdown. Shit, I missed my... Okay, this might be possible. I gotta dodge twice in a row right after throwing that punch. Damn it. Well, I got the timing wrong on that. Got another shot at it, though. Oh, man! I thought that was gonna knock him down. Alright, one for one. I'm hoping that the second knockdown, like, puts him down for good if he's at an 8 count on his first. And I at least, I know where I can, like, get a good opening to, like, start pummeling him, too, is, like, after the pattern's done. Yeah, I get hit a little bit, but whatever. I have an idea of how I can improve this next time, too. If I need to. Let's see if he stays down on 10. Oh, he gets up at 5. Oh my god, I got the judge's decision. Yes. Okay. Everything but the championship is just a low-fat snack. I'm going to devour these guys and satisfy my hunger with the heavyweight championship. Man, talk about one-dimensional character George Foreman is, huh? 4-1, 3-1. And then along the side we got 4-2-1, bottom 2-2-3, and then 2-1 along the side, and then 1 in the middle. Holy shit. So my thought for how I could have improved that is, like, obviously it does the pattern, the dun-dun-dun, and then I go after him. I was just letting that go for several cycles without punching him. I could have easily punched him, like, 2 or 3 times each time you finish that cycle, and then, you know, started the dodge again while waiting for him to do his charge. So that was my plan if I needed that extra bit of damage. So there we go. So next up, we're gonna have Eddie the Pirate Preston. Again, once I game over, I'm done for the night. So Eddie the Pirate Preston. The pirate isn't much for small talk. He usually lets his fists speak for him. He's a tough, well-trained boxer with his eye on the championship. That doesn't much either. It's amazing progress tonight. I honestly wasn't 100% sure I was going to get past the first belt. And I was ready to quit. until that aggro worked. I was ready to just give it up and try it again on Monday. Let's go full aggro on him too. Let's see what happens. Well, okay, so I tried to, like, hit him with an uppercut there, but I didn't need to. Oh, I almost got him. Damn, I was so close to getting him down twice. I landed 101 punches against him. That's funny. Ah, shit. I knew it was coming too, and I still... Whatever, the pirate seems to be easy enough. Probably knock me down at least one more time here. Oh, I had the timing, didn't I? Bullshit. Alright, so that's a good way to get the timing. After he does his first punch, I do a super, and then I can dodge the second one. Game over. That's gonna be where I stop for the day. That's not bad at all, though. We got three more fighters to go. Yeah.